Well, hello, boys and girls. I'm back from. Oh, look at that. See, I'm all disheveled. Still off. Okay, good enough. Well, I'm back from my little retreat with the life coach, and I need it because I went all of 500 yesterday. Some of the picks, it was a tough day. The two of the picks that I had wrong were pretty much coin flips, so you can't really do much about that. I was kind of surprised that the Canes didn't beat Detroit, but I think after the Locke incident there where he was hurt, I think maybe their minds kind of went off to another direction, and I think it was tough on everybody, actually. After that, it was anybody's game. Anyways, my life coach had some sound advice. She told me to up my naps and start fitting in some Roma clocks, maybe pre 11 a.m. and that way it will keep me level, you know. So yeah, it was good. It was good sound advice. Just have to do a little tweaking as I'm sitting at about 70-75% of my picks, and I like I said I like to hover around 80-90%. But I thank you for all your letters of concern about my apparel. I guess you can see I'm a little more properly dressed for you for the occasion. Of course, as you know, I am not wearing pants, and I support pants-free living, as you know. I suggest everybody does. I'll tell you, it takes the edge off of life. Anyways, we got lots of picks to get to, so I better get at them. We'll start with the Jets and the Devils. I believe this is a makeup game. This is an interesting affair, but I've been saying all along the Jets are a very good team. Goaltending is really their only struggle, and it's not that much of a struggle. I think Hellebuck will be in net. The Devils are at home, and they could win this. I feel sorry for Schneider because he's actually, his numbers don't represent how he's been playing. He just has a defense in front of him that can't really, that isn't really thinking the game at an NHL level the way it should. I think the Jets will likely win this. I'm going to say 4-2. I'm saying this hoping that Lion A is back. If anybody, I'm pretty sure he will be because he was just sick. So, Preds versus the Bruins. This is a tough game. The Preds have been playing on fire. I've actually got the Bruins here, but I think I'm going to actually switch it to the Preds. One thing you got to know is Laviolette is a master at getting people the best out of people at this time of year. And he's learned how to pace his team so they're at its best at this time of year. Before, he would just start like mid-season and just bag the crap out of them. But now he's sort of paced it. I'm going to change that. I'm going to say the Preds, mostly because the Bruins started playing a game when Cassidy came in. He started doing something that a lot of people probably figured that Julian should do. And he started playing a deep in forward game where you don't use the defense in the offensive zone. Basically, you try to keep the puck away from the defense. He realized that was his weakest part of his team, and it is a very weak part of his team. The problem is the system that you put in place like that is fairly easy to beat once people catch on what you're doing, and people are catching on what you're doing. Laviolette's too smart to not know that. I think I think with their defense and their way of playing, they'll probably take it 2-1. I had it 2-1 Bruins, but I'm changing it right now, so we'll see how that works out for me. Sens Flyers. The Flyers have been playing on a high. The Sens look like they're taking life too seriously right now. They need to loosen up a little bit, I think. I just have a feeling the Flyers are going to win this. I'm going to say 3-1. Wings, Canes. I think the Canes are going to be coming out hard, playing for Lack. They're going to play extremely tough. They're not going to let this one slide. I can't see them winning two or losing two in a row against the Wings. So I'm taking the Canes. I'm taking it 4-3. Sabres versus Jackets. Jackets are a very hardworking team right now, but the problem is they're having problems getting scoring. However, the Sabres played last night. Nielsen will probably be in net. I'm wondering if Korpisalo will be in the net for the Jackets. If Korpisalo is in net, I take the Sabres. If not, I'm taking the Jackets 5-2. I'm going to take the Jackets, assuming that they're not. Panthers versus the Leafs. I gotta figure the Leafs will take this one. The Panthers have been playing better, but they're young and inconsistent. And they still don't have Luongo or Ekblad. I think the Leafs will take this, but I think it'll be a high scoring affair, and I don't think it'll be overly a blowout, although it could be. 5-4. Stars, Habs. The Habs, Julian's doing what Julian does, and he's getting the best out of his teams, and he's doing it really quick with the Habs here now. I think the Habs will win 3-1. Caps, Wild, this is a tough game. I don't know what the Wild struggles are right now. Boudreaux is not happy with some of his players. I do know. They had an incredibly difficult schedule in the last half, and I think they're just tapped. With that being the case, they'll probably have a little more rest and play the Caps a little tougher, but I'm still going to take the Caps 3-2. Kings versus Oil. The Kings are just way too slow to beat the Oil. I think the Oil will beat them 9 out of 10 times the way they are right now. I have to take the Oil 3-2. Ducks versus the Canucks. This will probably be a tight affair. I've been saying that Willie Desjardins has the Canucks turning them into one of the hardest working teams in the league. Maybe the hardest. He kind of reminds me of what Tortorella did with the Rangers. What he's doing with the Canucks. If people are saying rumblings of him being fired, I think that would be ridiculous. Don't do that. Now back to the Ducks. I have to say, I undercut Carlisle here. I mean, I thought Boudreaux was a bad firing, and I still do. But Carlisle has really progressed his coaching style, and he's bringing in a lot of ideas that are not old school. He's been painted as an old school coach, but he hasn't been teaching that, hasn't been playing that way at all. He hasn't been coaching that way at all in Anaheim, really. I mean, he still has that ability or that side, but he's really taken a look at the league and where he needs to go and done it, and kudos to him for that. I think the Ducks will win. I'm saying 3-2. The Rangers versus the Sharks. The Sharks got to come out of their funk sometime, and the Rangers have been on a downward spiral, as I predicted for quite a while. I did not predict the Sharks to go down this bad, but I did predict them to go down a bit, simply because they're so old. However, I think that the Sharks will pull this one out. I'm going to say the Sharks 4-3. I would not bet on this, though. Don't bet on this game. It's just, you don't know, I don't even think they know who's going to win this one. Anyways, boys and girls, I'm going really long here. That's my full 42%. Make sure you got your Heimies. Make sure you're all lubed up there, boys and girls. You, Billy. Billy, use your lube. I don't want to hear it. Lube up. My NHL Pearls of Wisdom. See you tomorrow. Lots of love to you.